was October 13th, 1942, and it was the last night of the caribou. She was owned by Newfoundland Railway, Newfoundland's love and pride. She was 265 feet long, she was 41 feet wide. She carried 400 passengers, first and second class. Little did she know that night this trip would be her last. She left North Sydney Ferry Docks that night at 8 p.m. But big and tough in Taverner, standing at the helm, the minesweeper Grandmere was her escort for that night. But even with an escort, men felt something wasn't right. The night was dark and moonless as they moved into the strait. With a very strong southwest wind coming up around the cape, there's too much smoke from the funnel, men is heard to say. And it makes no sense to have the escort behind us all the way. U-69 lay southwest of Port of Bass, but two lookouts and their batteries charged, the crew largely at rest. The captain was ready for action, but he expected none that night. When the caribou belching heavy smoke suddenly came into sight, shortly after from the Grandmere Bridge a terrible sight was seen. It's reported there was one big flash, then clouds of smoke and steam. Torpedo from the German sub had made a direct hit. Now the job to find and sink the sub was left to the escort ship. Sub would not be caught that night, it would make its getaway. But before the war was over, the sub and crew would pay. The Grandmere returned for survivors, but the sea had taken its toll. For the Atlantic Ocean, that time of year is very rough and cold. It was October 13th, 1942, and it was the last night of the caribou. And it was the last night of the caribou.